Welcome to Applications Using Differentiation Techniques. We'll cover the constant rule, power rule, constant multiple rule, and the sum and difference rule within applications. The goals will be to find the equation of a tangent line and find the points on a function that have a horizontal tangent line. Let's take a look at an example. Find the equation of the tangent line at the point 414 to the function y equals x squared minus the square root of x. On our previous video, we discussed that we can't use the power rule when it's in radical form. So the first step will be to rewrite this with rational exponents. So we'll have y equals x squared minus x to the power of 1/2. Now, if we want to find the equation of the tangent line, of course, we're going to have to find the slope of that line. So if we find the derivative and evaluate it at x equals 4, we'll find the slope of that tangent line. Let's try it. Y prime is equal to the derivative of x squared, which would be 2x, minus the derivative of x to the 1/2, that would be 1/2 times x to the power of 1/2 minus 1, which would be negative 1/2. Now we'll simplify this. Simplifying this term, if I move this to the denominator, I'll have x to the positive 1/2 power, which is the same as the square root of x. Now I need to evaluate this when x is 4. So we'd have 2 times 4 minus 1 divided by 2 times the square root of 4. So y prime of 4 will be equal to 8 minus square root of 4 is 2 times this 2 would give us a negative 1/4 or minus 1/4, which would equal 31/4 or 7.75. Now this will be the slope of our tangent line, so now we need to find the equation of the tangent line, and we use point slope form. Just in case you don't remember that, here it is. Again, our slope is here, our point is here. This would give us y minus 14 is equal to 7.75 times the quantity x minus 4. We'll solve this for y. Add 14 to both sides, and we have y is equal to 7.75x minus 17. Okay, let's verify our work by looking at a graph. Here we have our function. Here we have the graph of our tangent line. Here's the point that was referred to in the problem, 414, and we can see that our line is tangent at that point, which verifies our work. Let's take a look at another example. Find the points on the function for which the tangent line would be horizontal. Well, all horizontal lines have a slope of 0. So on this problem, we need to find where the derivative will be equal to 0. Remember, the derivative gives us the slope of the tangent lines. So let's find our derivative and set it equal to 0. So the derivative of negative 1/3 x cubed would be negative 1/3 times the derivative of x cubed, which would be 3x squared, plus 6 times the derivative of x squared, that would be 2x, minus 11 times the derivative of x, that would be 1, and then minus derivative of 50, that'd be 0. Let's simplify here and set it equal to 0. Those three simplify. This would leave us with negative x squared plus 12x minus 11. Again, we want to know when this is equal to 0. That's where the tangent lines would be horizontal. Let's factor out the negative. Notice it changes the sign of all of the terms. And this does factor. The factors of positive 11 add to negative 12, that'd be negative 11 and a negative 1. So the solutions to this would be x equals 11 and x equals 1. Now these are the x coordinates, but they ask for the point, so we also have to find the y coordinates. So we need to find f of 11, that would give us the y coordinate when x is 11, and f of 1. Remember, we're going to sub these values back into the original function here, not the derivative. Save time, I've already done that. F of 11 is equal to 111.3 repeating, f of 1 is equal to negative 55.3 repeating. So the coordinates of the points where the tangent lines would be horizontal are 111.3 repeating and 1, negative 55.3 repeating. Again, let's verify it with a graph. In blue, we have our function. In red, you can see our two horizontal tangent lines. The points of tangency are the points that we found here and here. I would also like you to notice the relative extrema occur where the derivative is equal to 0. Here we have a relative minimum, and here we have a relative maximum. We'll come back to this idea. Thank you for watching. I hope that helps. Have a wonderful day.